Hey guys, for today's video, I'm going to be doing a sunflower themed makeup tutorial. Now, recently I've been getting more into fragrances, so I just want to show you guys my fragrance for today, and that is the Golden Sunflower Body Cream by Bath & Body Works. I just had to include this because it goes along perfectly with the aesthetic, and it smells really nice. So I'll just add some more on. And then I am also wearing the Sunflowers Sunlight Kiss perfume by Elizabeth Arden. So this is what it looks like. This smells so, so good. It's absolutely amazing. I'm just gonna add more on. My hands are all slippery because of the lotion. But this smells so good. It's a nice like amber type of warm scent, but it's not like an over the top amber scent either. It's just really nice, really pretty. It's got some other notes in there. I'm not sure what else though. Okay, so I will be using the Urban Decay Naked Honey palette for this look. I just thought it went along perfectly with the sunflower theme. So I'm going to be using the Lorac Behind the Scenes eye primer. This will be just what I'm going to put on my eyes right now. I did put on the NYX brow pencil that I always use, but I might add a little bit more on because I applied it not so recently. But yeah, I'm just going to be adding more of this on. I've been wanting to film this video for a while now, but I also wanted to film it before I ended up decluttering my Bath & Body Works lotion, because I will soon, and I wanted to include it in a video, like a sunflower theme. So I'm glad I'm doing it today. Okay, so this will just be the base for the eyes, just to make sure that the eyeshadow stays on longer. I'm gonna add a little bit more. I feel like I'm probably adding too much, but okay, so now that the eye primer's on, I'm going to fix my brows a little bit. I'm just using the NYX Micro Brow in the shade Taupe. So this is what it looks like. I'm just gonna fix them a little bit. I already did them earlier, but just to fix them a little bit, try to add more on. I'm not the best at doing brows in general, so bear with me. That's good for now. When I apply foundation, I feel like I might need to apply more on. So maybe I should hold off on that for a little bit. Okay, so we are using the Naked Honey palette, which is just such a beautiful palette. If you guys haven't seen it already, this is what it looks like. It's absolutely stunning. Now I gotta decide what shade I wanna go into. Okay, so I think I'm going to take the shade. I'm gonna take the shade Sweet, because I feel like Flyby has a little bit of shimmer or something in it. So I'm gonna take the shade Sweet. That's the second shade right here. It's this shade. And then I'm gonna apply it all over my lids. And this will be like the base shade. Plus, I'm going to be doing a pretty warm toned look, so I don't really want a completely white shade either. really like the shade. Oh, by the way, I am using the brush from the palette. It's the Naked Honey brush. But you guys can use whatever. I might switch off with my brushes, just so you guys know, because I do really like my e.l.f. ones. But the e.l.f. ones are super affordable too, so. Okay, next I'm taking the shade, I'm also using the big fluffy brush side. I'm going to take the shade Swarm. That is the like more warm tone shade right next to Sweet. And I'm just going to put it in the crease, just like that. I don't have like a zoom in on my phone, sorry. So that's why I haven't zoomed you guys in any of my videos. So I'll try to go closer to the camera. This is such a beautiful, like, mustardy kind of shade. It's absolutely stunning. I'm also applying it on my outer third of my lid. Not, like, too much in, just, like, right here. Because I just want to make sure I'm starting to apply something to that outer area as well. And not just the crease. Okay, so I might, you know what, I think I'm going to take a different brush because I think it'll be a little bit more easy to get. I'm going to take the e.l.f. This is the blending eye brush. I'm going to take the same shade, Swarm, and I'm going to apply it to the outer third and then in the crease, just like that. Making sure that it looks really nice and warm tone. Which is what I'm going for because I'm creating a very golden look, which will go really nicely with the outfit that I'm wearing in the sunflower theme. Okay, so next I'm going to take the shade Keeper. That's another warm tone shade. It's really beautiful. It's a little bit more on the brown side, but it's still kind of that mustard undertone to it. So I hope you guys can see that. It's hard with this phone camera. But this shade is so pretty. I love the warm tones in here. Absolutely love them. And I feel like these shades look really nice on a lot of different eye colors as well. Okay, next I'm going to take a smaller brush. Let me see which one I want to take. So this is the e.l.f. e.l.f. eye crease brush. So it's a little bit smaller. This is what I use for my shimmers a lot of times. I'm taking the shade Keeper again, and I'm just going to apply it on the outer corner and in the crease. And the main reason is because I want to focus more color, more depth in those areas. Oh no. Okay. Getting like a different. Hold up. Okay. That looks better. I was getting a different color. Hold on. Let me take a different brush. Okay, this is the same brush. I just took a different one. It looks like the other one had some other pigment on it that I don't want. So I'm going to take this one. It's kind of like a mustardy kind of brown shade, but it's so pretty. So Keeper on both sides, the in or outer third of the lid, taking it into the crease. Just like that. Okay, so now we've got a pretty golden look to the eye. So now I want to create even more depth in that outer part. So I'm going to take the shade High, which is also pretty golden. And I'm going to apply it to, but this one's deeper. Apply it to the outer third and into the crease. And it's just going to create more depth, which is what we want. I wish more people did makeup tutorials on YouTube, because I want to do like a lot of those videos, but I like literally don't never see people do them, like very rarely. But I will, because I just like doing them. So okay, so I am creating even darker shades here. So I'm going to keep it that way for now, and then I'll probably come back. Actually, I might add, you know what, I'm going to start to add Sting, and I'm going to put it on the outer V. So we can create even more depth going on, which is what I want. And I'm kind of putting in the crease too, not just the outer V. But I want all that depth back into the eye. Okay. So now it's almost to my favorite part. Almost there, guys, to the best part of the look. Okay, let me see. Not completely the same yet. Keep dragging this color. Try to get more pigment to this side so it matches on the other side. Okay, so next I'm gonna take this is the same brush, but I just used a different one. This, a different one that wouldn't have color on it. So this is the e.l.f. eye crease brush. So what I'm going to do, you can also use the Naked Honey and just use the flat side, this side right here. So I'm going to take this. I might use this, might not. I'm going to take the shade Honey. That is that beautiful yellow gold shade. So right here, it's the most bright yellow shade in the palette, yellow gold. So I'm going to apply it just like this, and this is going to be the main focus of the eye, because we are trying to create that sunflower beautifulness. This is such a beautiful shade. Oh my gosh, so pretty. It is very, very yellow gold though, so just so you guys know, if you get this palette or you try to use the shade for the first time, it is a very yellow gold, but it's absolutely stunning. So now you guys can see what I'm trying to go for, hopefully. Just to create like that beautiful dimension to the eyes. Sometimes I mix it with the golden shade, but for this look, because I'm doing sunflower, I kind of just want to keep the yellow in the shade the way it is. I don't think I need to spray my brush, so I don't think I will. I'll just leave it the way it is. Oh yes, yes, that is the look. That's the look that I am going for. Really making this pop. Okay. I'll probably need to bring back the brown just a little bit anyway, so I'll edit again. Okay, so I can't decide here if I want to do... I'm going to start off, guys. So I'm going to use... This is the Pacifica Pineapple Flower Oil-Free Matte Mist. I'm just using this as a setting spray. You guys can use whatever. And I'm spraying my brush. This is the e.l.f. Small Precision Brush. I'm going to take this highlighter shade. I'll show you guys. Revlon Skin Lights in the shade Daybreak Glimmer. Any of these are really beautiful. So just use whatever. Let me see here. I can't decide if I want to use it completely right now. Or if I'm just going to take a shade from the palette. We'll see. Oh no, I didn't open it yet. So I kind of did it to myself, didn't I? Okay, here we go. So this is the highlighter. It's absolutely stunning. I'm not sure if I want to use it completely for the inner corner. I'm going to try and see how it looks. I might end up going back into the honey palette just because it's way more pigmented. We're going to see. I love this highlighter. I would do it with any other look, but I might not want to do it with this lip. Just depends. Oh, that is pretty though. So normally I'd keep this highlighter, but I think for the sake of this look, I'm going to hold off on that one. And I'm just going to apply the same shade from the palette. So I'm going to apply honey. I'm going to use honey instead because I want it to be kind of match the gold shade that I'm putting on. So we'll just put on honey and that'll be easier. Yeah, I just want to match. We'll use honey. It'll look better. Put a lot on. So my inner corner barely shows up because of the way my eyes are shaped. So I am just packing on this shade like crazy just to get it to show up. And apply more. So I'm using that small precision brush and I'm just putting more on. It's really gonna make eyes pop. Just applying more to the lid. Okay. So that's what I'm going for here. Just a very bright gold yellow shade. Oh, by the way, I did kind of wet the brush anyways, so just so you guys know, it makes it pop more that way, and so I pretty much did it that way. Okay, so now that I have the eyeshadow on, I'm going to be applying more of the brown on the outer parts of the lid. So I'm going to use the e.l.f. Eye Crease Brush, and I'm going to take the shade Hive again. So I'm going to take Hive and I'm just going to apply it right here. You guys can see. Just to give some more depth to the outer third of my eye. So it's not all just gold, you know. And then I'm going to take Sting on top of it. Just to deepen it more. Just like that. Because we want to have some depth in the outer corner. You don't have to, but I think it looks a little bit more cohesive. And I'm going to take some in the crease too. Okay, so now that I'm pretty much done my eyeshadow, I'm going to start doing my face makeup. Let me fix shimmer fallout that I have. It's kind of crazy right now. Okay, so I'm gonna spray my beauty blender with the same mist. It's the pineapple flower. I don't usually do this, but I'm doing it for this look. I'm going to take the Wet n Wild Photo Focus foundation. So I want to put on concealer first or just put on foundation. So I think I'm going to apply concealer first. Yeah, let's do that. So this is the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. It's in the shade Light, I believe. I'm just going to apply it to my under eyes first because this shade's a little bit light right now on me. And I rather like fix it with the foundation first. If it's too light. Wow, I applied a lot on an accident. Kind of clean this up because I have pretty deep set eyes, so I kind of want to get in all the corners. Okay. Because I have really baggy under eyes. So now I've applied the concealer. Now it's time for the foundation. So I'm going to spray my brush again. I feel like it kind of went away. I'm going to take the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. This is the dewy one. I like the original one, but I don't see that one much anymore. I just see matte or dewy, and right now I do dewy because matte's almost too dry. So I'm going to apply it on here like this. I'm going to put it on my face. Got it aside. I think I'm going to apply it to my neck too. Just so it looks a little bit more cohesive. I've been trying not to put foundation on my neck, but for this video, I think it will. Apply more to my neck, so like that. try to avoid getting it on my outfit. This is like why I hate putting on foundation, is like it just gets all over my clothes. I know I've said that before, but it's really annoying. And I've been trying to put on bronzer, but instead of foundation, but for today, I'm putting on the foundation. Because I don't know how much this matches me, but I want to create more of a golden type of glow. I don't want to be too light on my foundation either, because I'm kind of wearing like golds and everything. So that's why I picked this foundation. I think it goes more. Even if it doesn't match perfectly. Let's see. Okay, it looks pretty decent now. I'm gonna blend it a little bit more. I might add a little bit more. Kind of adding a lot, but it's okay. So it takes kind of a while to blend foundation for me, which is why I'm not huge on using it in videos. But yeah, that's pretty much what I'm doing. Okay, so now that I've applied the foundation, I'm going to use bronzer. And I'm a big believer in bronzer. Big believer. So the bronzer that I'm going to use two different ones. I've been doing this lately. I'm using the Physician's Formula Butter Bronzer in the shade Endless Summer. And then I'm using the Physician's Formula Butter Coffee Bronzer in the shade Latte. So these are the two shades. So I'm going to start off with the deeper one, which is the Endless Summer. I'm using the Real Techniques brush. This is what it looks like, and this is the 401 blush brush, and this is what I use to apply my bronzer. So normally I've just been using bronzer on my neck, but for today's video I did use foundation just to make it look a little bit more cohesive. I'm gonna try to blend because I have so much open area with this shirt, so I don't want it to look too crazy, you know what I mean? If it doesn't match perfectly, which I'm really bad with matching my foundations to my actual skin tone. So I'll apply more on my face. I really love bronzer. I just think it looks so much better when I put on bronzer of any kind. I don't always wear it with foundation. Sometimes I wear it by itself. And it looks fine, but I have to really blend if I do it that way. So I'm gonna apply it a little bit onto, I don't usually apply it here, but since I'm wearing like a totally open shirt like this, or open romper, I'm gonna do it this way. So we're really using bronzer everywhere. And it's kind of going to go along with that sun-kissed glow. I know most people do it where you use a C, but for me, I just feel like I'm too pale to do that. So we're going to do it this way. I feel like I use my bronzers too as like a setting powder instead of using a setting powder, but that's just me. Okay. Next, I'm going to take the Butter Coffee Bronzer. I feel like this one's a little bit of a different tone, and I think it just adds to the look a little bit more. So I'd like to blend the two. But I originally got this one because I just love the smell of it, which I really do. It smells so good. It smells like either like a hazelnut or caramel latte. I can't really tell. Kind of like a caramel one, maybe. Okay, so we're pretty much, I'm just blending in my foundation because around my nose is pretty dry, so it doesn't want to stick there, and I always have that issue. Okay, I'm done with that. Okay, moving on. So I'm going to use two different blushes today because I can't decide between the two. I'm going to use the Burt's Bees blush in the shade Toasted Cinnamon. This has been one of my favorites for a while. I might use, I can't decide what I want to do. So I'm going to use the bigger brush, this one. But I'm going to apply it like this, so it's not so, it still has that technique because I have pretty big cheeks and I don't want it to look too crazy. It here too. I used to apply it all over my cheeks, but my face is pretty round, and I have, when I smile, I have pretty big cheeks. And I don't have a high cheekbone at all. My cheekbone's very low, so gotta work with what you have. Okay. So this just kind of adds to like a sun-kissed kind of look in my opinion because it looks slightly like a bronzer. It's like between a bronzer and a blush. It's really pretty though. I might add it a little bit to my nose because it's so like bronzery anyways. Okay, that looks nice because I want to do like a more sun-kissed look. Next, I'm going to add a different blush on top. This is the Burt's Bees blush in the shade Bare Peach. This is the second blush I'm applying. I actually think the Toasted Cinnamon looks good by itself. So I'm going to use the Real Techniques brush to apply it. I'm not sure which one it is. Sorry. I don't know if it's faded or if it doesn't have it on here. But it looks like this, so just know that. So I'm going to apply it like right here. And just to give it more of like a peachy glow, because I feel like the Toasted Cinnamon was nice. I actually really like the Toasted Cinnamon by itself. But I'm going to add this too. Just to give it a little bit more peachiness. Not just the Toasted Cinnamon shade. I want to look very bronzed. I mean, I don't because I'm not super tan, but we're gonna try, okay? I'm working with what I got. Okay, I think that's enough blush. I always overdo it in these videos. Okay, next I'm gonna take my favorite highlighter of all time. This is the same one I was gonna try to apply in my inner corner. Revlon Skin Lights in the shade Daybreak Glimmer. So we're going to apply it to the cheeks. And I'm just going to apply it kind of like in a C type of shape. Yes, because I want that glow. I literally live for this highlighter. It's so pretty. My favorite highlighter ever. Actually, I've been really liking the Becca one recently. I got it from TJ Maxx Opal, so I really like that one too. They're both really nice. They're about even for me. Okay. Yes. Both so beautiful. Absolutely. I'm obsessed. So now that I got the highlighter on, I'm going to... Oh my gosh, I can't believe I'm going to do this again, but I'm going to use the NYX brow pencil. Sorry, guys. I'm going to use to fix this brow just to make sure, because sometimes foundation gets on my brows. I'm just going to kind of go over it again. So just like that, light. Underneath. Okay. Just like that, guys. Okay, that looks a lot better. Next. What's next? I'm gonna apply. This is a liner. This is the Maybelline Espresso retractable or eyeliner. It is a retractable one though. Okay, so this is just like a deep dark espresso brown, and I'm just going to use it to apply it on my waterline like that. And I don't know if I want to use it on my bottom. I think I'm going to leave my bottom. I'm just using it on my waterline, so nothing crazy. I'll see how it looks like with the lashes. So I'm going to apply the Essence Lash Princess mascara. I'm going to be using lashes, though, but I'll do that in a separate video. I'm going to use the Pro Beauty Wispies. I'm not good at applying lashes on camera, so I'll show you guys in the next video how it looks with the lashes. But for this video, we'll just use the mascara. I love this mascara so much. It's so, so beautiful. I'm gonna apply it to my top lashes just for now, and then if I apply it on my lower lashes, I'll show you that in the next video, which I'll just show you guys what it looks like with the lashes on. So it looks really pretty with just the mascara, but I'm trying to recreate an old look that I did, so that's why I'm going to use the lashes. Okay, so I actually really like it just by itself with mascara. This is how I would wear it on a day-to-day basis. Try to make the most of this too. Okay, so this is what it looks like just by using mascara. So I'll leave it like that for now because I'm gonna be adding lashes in the next video anyways. Let's see here. Now, these lashes though, these are stunning. I've used these before. I just got a new pair recently, so these are new. But I want to show you. Well, these themselves I've used before, but this is what the lash looks like. So it's really beautiful. Looks really nice on the eyes. And that's what I'll be putting on. Okay, now I have one more stop to share with you guys before I close out this video. I'm gonna be adding some lipstick. So pretty much done with this look. I'm gonna add the Velvet Teddy lipstick. I want to see how it looks with just this before I decide if I add the other color. So Velvet Teddy, you know what? I'll show you guys both ways. I think Velvet Teddy would be the way to go with this look, though. I love brown nudes with yellow. I think that goes really well. I'm gonna apply Whirl too. I can't decide which one I want to keep. Okay, I think both look good. I think I would stick with the Velvet Teddy one, though. Apply more of that one on. All right, you guys, so this is the final look. Thank you guys so much for watching and hope you guys have a great day.